There we go. Lightning did not strike twice for Moreton City. Excelsior victory in the end. Too professional, too good. And into the semi-finals for the fourth time in their history as Panikis Norbo moves to within one game of a major final in just his third game in charge of Melbourne victory. Two goals for Nikos Virkos in the first half. One for Casey Boss gave him a 3-0 lead at the break. Moreton City did try to take the game to them in the second half. And they created one or two chances. A couple of good saves made by Jack Duncan to preserve victory's clean sheet. And then on the breakaway, Nishan Velukale adding a fourth, his fifth goal of this Australia Cup run, which takes Melbourne victory into the semis. Full-time at Perry Park, Moreton City Excelsior 0, Melbourne victory 4. And overall, a thoroughly professional display by the professional club, Andy Harper.
Yeah, indeed. And Moreton City have given us a lot to think about, a lot to talk about in their performances in the Cup, and big congratulations to them. But the golfing class was clearly evident when it really mattered here, and that's in both penalty areas. Moreton City created some good football but couldn't get the chances past a resolute victory defence who, as much as they slackened off, if I can use that term, in the second half, were evidently just too good for the likes of Marquez Walters to get through them. But it's one example of, and one of the reasons why this Cup competition is so fresh and green and so wonderful, that these clubs from all over Australia get to put themselves on a national stage, show themselves what they're about, show their club's colours and badges and history, and what they've got to offer the national scene. And certainly Moreton City have done that in spades in this Cup run. It comes to an end here at Perry Park. So to our visit to the home of football in Queensland for another Cup season, which is another story. But Melbourne victory march on to a familiar place, which is close to the top of the pile, where they'll challenge for the silverware again.
All right, let's have a look at the highlights. Casey Bosland to go away will be a concern perhaps for Panikis Norbo, but he was part of a very good victory performance. It all started in the ninth minute. Arzani's free kick and Nikos Virkos with the first of his two goals, Andy.
So much of this goal sort of summed up victory's performance tonight. When they needed it, they were spot on and very clinical. And that delivery from Arzani was pinpoint, and so efficient was the finish from Nikos Virkos. And then it was Mashash going through the gears in midfield. Moreton City had nothing to put to him to stop him from making this incursion and then really setting up the attack. This is a good reward for Jordi Valadon, who works really hard and very impressively without a lot of mentions, but he's the one who put on that assist for the second goal. This is a disappointing one for Moreton City. Defending for them was difficult tonight when Melbourne Victory decided they had a point to make. So when it came, and they've really turned one up for them, and Casey Boss makes it 3, and the game's sort of out of their reach. They played well thereafter, but 3 just tightens the vessels that little bit more and makes the belief a little bit harder. And it was a good finish from Casey Boss. I share your concern with him limping off. They'll be wanting to watch that. Might just be cramp. Let's hope it's nothing worse. And then, in the face of what has been a relentless series of attacks from Moreton City, Daniel Arzani with the first-time pass to the on-running Nishan Velupalay, who's doing pretty well in this Cup, as you've reported a couple of times already this evening, Simon. In full flight with a really controlled finish over the top of Nathan Foster to finish the deal here for victory. Take all the oxygen out of them. Moreton City, the campaign, and it was just sailing home from there for the victory, 4-0.
Yep, his fifth goal of this Australia Cup run, which puts him out at the top. Here's the full-time match stats. Well, there you go. Moreton City Excelsior actually mustered up 12 shots, which was 3 more than Melbourne Victory. But in terms of on target, 5 apiece, and Victory converted 4 of those. Those possession stats certainly equaled up a fair bit in the second half. And Moreton City also won the corner count quite comfortably. But it's goals that count, and Victory got the 4 that mattered this evening. And there they are with the flag that says and confirms that they are the semi-finalists. One of them, along with Adelaide United, MacArthur, and of course South Melbourne. And this is how they line up. Probably next weekend That to be confirmed on Monday by Football Australia. South Melbourne will entertain MacArthur, and it's Adelaide United against Melbourne Victory in an original rivalry semi-final in South Australia. An enjoyable night at Perry Park. It's been an enjoyable cup run for Moreton City Excelsior, but it came to an end tonight. Melbourne Victory beating them by 4-0. Will we see Marcus Walters? Will we see Ben Holiday in the A-League season when it starts in October? They've given a great account of themselves. Hope you enjoyed our coverage. From me, Simon Hill, Andy Harper and the rest of the template team, a very good night to you.